well, here we go. I'm David Owen, OCOM Sales, and I just received my very first AirComp Vision fully motorized Omnidome. It's the Generation 3. This is a product shown at ASIS 2016 and ISC West 2017. This probably, historically, is one of the most advanced CCTV cameras ever developed in the industry. Let's take a look at here at our part number. It's a AV12376, six standing for a WDR RS. And of course we have our MAC address that identifies the serial number and all uses of the camera. So let's crack the can, shall we? Take this thing out of the box and we'll see what comes with it. As we have a mounting template. All right. So that's in the bag. We have a Omni 3 quick install instructions for hanging the camera and showing where some of the plates and connectors are. We have the mini disc that comes with each camera, which provides the software to help set IP addresses and such. Also, you can easily download the AVIP tool from the website to be able to search and manage addresses. This is a larger AirComp Vision camera than the other Omnis that we've seen out in the marketplace. So inside the box in our packaging here, we've got rubber grommets. These are the new grommet seals AirComp introduced a couple years ago that will seal for outdoor moisture use. We have mounting screws for what appears to be a drywall, a security torque wrench, and a external cable, which appears to be for both power and contacts for alarm controls. So that's what's inside the box, and we'll set this aside. Let's take this out. And this is what happens when you use a handheld video camera to take a picture. Let's unscrew this and find out how we're going to get inside the box. I've actually done a little pre-unscrewing. There are four screws on this dome. Let's pull off the top. It comes with a foam insert inside the dome cover to protect it during shipping. So this comes out after. We'll just simply pull this away. I recommend saving this along with the box. Yes, in service, sometimes we have to return things for service, and it would be helpful to have that back inside the dome if it ever has to be shipped. Also inside the dome cover, I see that we have the mask out inside the center of the dome. This can peel out. You can just simply, if you wish to have a center firing camera, if that is the case on this camera. Totally different. This camera has a completely different mounting setup than any of the previous Omnidomes. There are two more screws located here at the base, which will release a base plate on the backside. The base plate gets mounted to the ceiling, and then we have access inside the backside of the camera. So I'm just going to loosen these up, and we will see where we go next. Be really different. I see that what we have here is a base plate, even indicating what is the front mounting portion, which, by the way, lines you up with the conduit knockout plug so that it can be properly installed. This bottom plate has an actual ring that just simply slips off of a secure net. So you can mount this plate to a ceiling and then attach the camera, it will hang. Also now appears that I have access to the backside of the camera. After taking off the ceiling mount bracket, I see we have another plate underneath the camera where the connection for the IP circuitry is located. I see three Phillips head screwdrivers, and only one of them is actually seated. My recommendation is, if we have to flip this over on a table, let's take our top and let's turn that top over and put the camera so it doesn't rest on top of the camera imagers themselves. It can rest on the base of the camera as such. And now I can loosen the screw that will enable me to remove this plate. Now I have access to the IP connection, and there's also the quick connection for 12 or 24 volt power and the contacts for alarm connection. Also noticing that this is different in the sense that the actual connection for the IP is not on the top side, the camera side, as the previous Gen 1 and Gen 2 Omnidomes are. It's now located on the back side. We'll see where the LED lights show up when they initiate as well. To apply my IP connector, one of the things I can see is that I have a space limitation. I have a pre-molded connector that I like to use with a female on the other side, but this is too long of a jacket, so we'll have to choose a cable accordingly. They're pre-molded category cable with a jacketed end, but this one will easily fit into the space, and I've already got it threaded through the back plate so that it can be sealed up inside the housing. The grommets that come with this will actually cover the holes for additional reinforcement against moisture when mounted outdoors. A different tool, it's called a jacket insertion tool. You put this over the end of your IP cable so that when you use to insert it through the grommet hole in the plate, it'll actually fit through the grommet. Let's try that. This was a two-handed job. I got the grommet started by pulling it over the insertion tool tip. This way I can pull the grommet down over the head of the IP cable that's pre-molded without tearing anything up. Now I've actually pulled the grommet over the category cable and I fitted it into the mounting plate. I can now remove the insertion cover for the tip of the RJ45 so I can connect that. The grommet is provided either with the hole for the external power and contact accessory cable or a solid grommet just to plug the second hole, which I'm going to do now. Applied, and I would say I took about 3 minutes getting that all established. And I'll simply now tighten down the screws for the back cover plate, which also has an additional sealed rubber gasket, it looks like, for additional increased moisture control. So really, this is a total redesign of an access port for an AirConnect camera. It looks to be over-engineered to guard against moisture. Now I believe I'm ready to mount my new G3 camera. The mounting template, if you need to drill a hole pattern, is also provided in the box. Comes in the form of a sticker so that it easily applies to a solid surface. So you can pre-drill your mounting holes. Simply mount the plate and then you'll be able to hang the camera from the plate, and then using the two locking set screws at the front, you'll be able to secure it in position. I'm going to move not to mounting it to a ceiling, but to hooking it up to the laptop. Now that we have the new Omnidome G3 out of the box, we're going to hook it up to the software. We've discovered our IP address at 192.168.1.18, and we've opened this up in Chrome to give us our display. Something that's nice that was started in the Gen 2 product, every time you highlight over an individual window, the camera number now appears on the screen. You'll also see it cuts off a little bit. That's because this the view display in the web page is being cropped. Also, if we need to confirm the firmware, MAC address, part number, it's now easily displayed. That's new. It's right on the desktop. In addition to which, some of the buttons are new. For example, there is now a presets button, in which if we select the presets and we look down below, we get a new display. Preset and home state. That sounds a little bit like a pan and tilt. It's locations. We want to change this to either a 360, a 180, or a 270. We can select presets and let's see what happens. I've hit the button and right away we see that the camera is moving. I'm going to time and see how long it takes to move the imagers into position. We've set it for the 180 preset. And you can see the imagers are moving around on the outer dial.
I've noticed that it does not appear that there is a way to manually move the sensors into position. They appear to be entirely controlled by motors for the movement around the outer ring, the tilt up or down, the zoom in or out, and the focus. We've been running about a minute now. And it seems to have done. Selected a 270 preset on the camera and the sensors have been moved into position, and now as a final step it's doing the focus and zoom. There is now a message that gives us the status of the setup, and overall I would say it's averaging about 4 minutes to conduct a complete setup with the focus itself. It goes through each individual camera one at a time and steps and walks through the focus setup.